Hello and welcome. In this tutorial, we'll have a look at HALCON object detection. After a short introduction of this deep learning technology, we'll go through the first program in this HDevelop example series. First, what is object detection? With object detection, you can locate and classify object instances in one step. Even when objects are overlapping, the individual instances are detected separately. Thus, object detection can be used in applications to check the presence of objects, count objects, locate objects, and, for example, defects, and much more. Deep learning object detection can be especially useful when traditional machine learning reaches its limits, for example, with natural objects containing a lot of variation and complex features. Now, let's have a look at the aforementioned HDevelop example series. The ultimate goal of the application is to check the content of this pill bag. Every pill type should be contained exactly once. In this video, you'll learn how to read and split labeled data, how to create a deep learning object detection model, and how to pre-process the labeled data in preparation of training with the created model. Let's go through the example step by step. The first section of these examples contains a detailed explanation of the subsequent steps. For this video, I'll skip over this part. Next, there is a section where all the relevant parameters are set. I'll explain the most important ones as we go through the example. To adapt this example for your own application, you'll mainly work with this part of the example. To get started, we first read a data set that we have saved in the COCO format. Alternatively, you can use read_dict to read a dataset that you labeled with the deep learning tool. The deep learning tool is a new product by MVTech with quickly evolving functionality. Check out the newest version on our website. Next, the dataset is split into three subsets. The training data will be used directly as input for the training operator. The validation data is used to check and visualize the training progress and thus adapt hyperparameters, which, simply put, are parameters that are not learned by the model but have to be specified by the user. Lastly, the test data is used for an independent evaluation after the training. The procedure split_dl dataset randomly splits the dataset using the given percentages. Thereby, it maintains the class distribution of the dataset. Note that the subsets should be independent, and each subset should be representative of the entire dataset. Next, we need to create the deep learning object detection model. One of the first things to consider is the image size that you want to use. Selecting the image size is a compromise between speed and performance. Here, we can scale down the images to a relatively small size. Based on the image size, we can then use the procedure determine_dl_model_detdet_detom. This procedure automatically estimates some advanced parameters of the model for the given dataset. We highly recommend using this procedure to optimize your training and inference performance. You can retrieve the results from the output dictionary using get_dict_tuple. More information on these anchor parameters can be found in the chapter reference of object detection. Then we create a dictionary with all the model parameters and create the model. The parameter backbone defines the pre-trained network to be used to train the model for your application. HALCON includes a variety of such pre-trained networks. As a rule of thumb, try to train your application with the compact network first. It's suitable for a lot of different applications. As with all handled data, you can inspect the model for more information. Lastly, we save the deep learning model to a file so that we can train it in the next video. As a last step in this program, we pre-process the dataset. Using the procedure create_dl_preprocess_param_from_model, we get a dictionary with appropriate pre-processing parameters. Then we pre-process the dataset. Since a lot of data is read and written, this step might take a while, especially if you're working with network-based storage. As a last step in the example, a random selection of the preprocessed data is visualized. Thus, you can check whether the relevant features for the detection are still visible with the reduced image size. Note Dev Display DL Data. It's a powerful procedure to visualize your input and output data. This concludes this tutorial. The next step is to train the object detection model. Thank you for watching.